Are you just starting your GED studying? Then you don't want to miss this video. Hi, this is Parker from Test Prep Champions, teaching you how to pass the GED fast. You can get started by clicking subscribe down below. So if you're new to GED studying and you consider yourself a GED beginner, then this is the video that you want to watch and make sure you really understand, because I'm going to give you some tips and tricks in this video that are going to help you start making headway with your GED studying. I'm going to tell you some of the basic ins and outs you need to know about the GED test, and ultimately try to save you some time and frustration as you move on to bigger and better things in life. And really, that's a key theme with the GED test, because I'm willing to bet that you're here right now for a certain reason. And obviously, I don't know your given circumstances, but as you sit there listening to me and watching this video, I'm sure that you don't want to pass just so that you can get a piece of paper that has your name on it and says that you passed. I'm sure that there's a deeper reason why you want to pass. For example, just not that long ago, I was talking to a woman on one of my GED test live streams where I help people and take live questions, and she was saying that the reason that she wanted to pass the GED test was because she wants to better provide for her daughter. She's a single mother and she already had a job, but she wanted to pass the GED test so that she could get promoted and start making more money so she could better provide for her daughters. And maybe that's why you want to pass the GED. Maybe you want to pass, get a better job, make more money for yourself so that you can do better financially for your in your own life, but also maybe for your family or for other people around you. Now, maybe you want to pass the GED test so that you can go on for college or to go on and learn a trade or to go on for further education. And if that's your reason, then again, I want to congratulate you and applaud you, because the GED is a great stepping stone onto further educational opportunities. And maybe you just want more personal fulfillment. You just want to achieve the GED test. You want to pass it and you just want that diploma. But it's not just about that piece of paper. It's really about the satisfaction you'll get from knowing that you achieved something. So whatever your reason for wanting to pass the GED test, first of all, congratulations. And the first bit of advice that I have to give you is don't be afraid to ask for help. Don't be afraid to struggle. Don't be afraid to admit that you're struggling, because the GED test is just like anything in life. There are going to be ups and downs. There are going to be hard days. There are going to be easy days. It can be a bit of an emotional roller coaster for some people. So just be ready for that. So be warned right now that, you know, hey, look, if things go up and down throughout your GED studying, just know that that's normal. If you feel like you're going backwards, or if you feel like you're stuck and you're confused, don't get too frustrated, okay? There will be some frustrating days, like most people do. Very few people just start their studying and just from point A to point B just go through very smoothly. Now, I hope that you do. I hope that everything goes smoothly from today and the rest of the time that you're studying for the GED test, but no one understands that for most people, there are going to be ups and downs, just like anything else in life. It's probably not going to go 100% smoothly all of the time. So you just have to understand right now from the get-go that it's okay to struggle. So during the time that you're studying for the GED test, know that when I say struggle, I don't mean that it's going to be that hard. It's not going to be like complete torture and complete agony. It shouldn't be that hard. And if it is, you really need to slow down. But what I mean by struggling is that when you're trying to do something new, like pass the GED test, you're going to be learning new skills. In most cases, if you never really did well in math before, say, or if you just never really considered yourself a math person, but now you have to learn math, for example, there's going to be a little bit of struggle involved. There's going to be a little bit of frustration as you learn it, but know that that is normal and that you've got to push through that frustration. You've got to push through that struggle, because on the other side of that comes understanding, and you're going to gain more intuition. You're going to start seeing patterns as you practice math more, but understand that if you're just learning math for the first time, it's not going to click right away for most people, and so therefore you're going to have to push yourself and you're going to have to push through some frustration and a little bit of pain in order to get to that other side. Now, that being said, if you're struggling a lot and you're really, really frustrated, then you might need to slow down. You might need to get help from a tutor or get help from a class, go join a class or do something like that, okay? Now, that's a whole nother topic, but as far as should you join a class or not, my stance on that is that for most people, it's not necessary to join a GED test prep class, but for some people, classes really do help and they really do make a big difference, but that's a topic for another video. So that's the first piece of advice that I have for you, is to not be afraid to admit when you're confused and when you're lost. Don't take it personally if you're struggling. It doesn't mean that you're not smart. It really doesn't have that much to do with it. If you don't learn math right away, it just means that it might take you a little bit longer to master math, but eventually you will be able to do it. It doesn't mean, oh, you're not smart because you can't learn math in 10 minutes or 20 minutes or a few days, okay? That's not what it means. So don't take things personally if along the way you hit some bumps in the road or you have some trouble with the math or the science or the language arts, okay? If things, unless you're a total genius and you just whiz right through everything, which is very, 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 very few people, okay, you are gonna have to put some work in, you're gonna have to put some time in to understand this stuff. You're really gonna have to wrestle with some of these topics in the math and the science and the reading language arts. It's gonna take some time, it's gonna take some effort. It's not gonna be like that much effort, and it's not gonna be that hard, but I'm not saying it's gonna be like insanely difficult, okay? It's not like you're doing like astrophysics here or something like that, like rocket science, but it is gonna be challenging. And so you have to be realistic about the fact that a lot of the stuff that you're gonna learn, you're probably not gonna get right away, and it's not a reflection on you. It doesn't mean that you're not smart. It doesn't mean that you can't do it. It just means that you're trying to learn something new. You're probably not gonna get it all right away. Very few people do get it right away and get it just like that, get it instantly. So have realistic expectations about yourself. Don't take it personally if you have ups and downs, and if you can't learn something right away, give it some time and some patience and you will get it, okay? Trust me, everybody that's watching this video, if you put in the time and you have some patience and some perseverance, okay, you can learn almost any math topic. I've seen students with learning disabilities that the so-called experts said that they would not be able to do math. I've seen them master math because they were patient and they listened and they followed instructions and they were able to do it despite what people said. Okay, so no matter where you're at, I'm confident that if you put the time in, you put the effort in, and even if you get frustrated, you know, take a break, go cool off, come back, open the book again, and you're gonna be able to learn this math. So that's another thing that's really important as a GED test prep beginner, is to have a healthy and realistic sense of how hard this is going to be. So you shouldn't be getting demoralized and just completely getting beat down by your studying. Some people do feel that way, and if you do feel that way, I really want you to take a step back from it and maybe get some help. Talk to somebody who you know, a friend or a sibling or somebody in your life who's good at math or has already done something like this, even a friend that's passed the GED, and ask them for help, okay? What I'm talking about is that there's gonna be a normal level of frustration and a normal level of struggle that is gonna come up along the way. But if you start feeling like, you know, that's getting out of hand and you start feeling really frustrated and really stuck or anxious or depressed, you need to get help from somebody. You need to talk to somebody or maybe even get a professional involved, okay? That brings me to another point here, is that while you study for the GED, you've got to take care of your mental health and you've got to take care of your physical health. So many times in life, we say that, you know what, after I pass the GED and I get a better job and I go into college, then I'll take care of my health, then I'll exercise better, then I'll eat better, then I'll get more rest. But in many cases, then you're just never going to do it. Once you get that better job, then you're going to say, you know what, maybe next year, maybe in January for my New Year's resolution, then I'll eat better, then I'll be healthier, then I'll sleep better. No, you got to do that now. So you got to get those other areas of your life in balance. I'm telling you, okay, if you take the time to get better sleep at night, get 7 to 9 hours of sleep and start to really eat better, eat healthier and exercise, you don't have to be like running 5Ks and marathons, okay? I'm not going to be running marathons, okay? I maybe could run the first mile and then I'd be walking after that. So I'm not saying you have to be this super like super fit person, this super healthy eater, but I'm just saying if you take care of those things like eating well, staying hydrated and getting sleep, at least most nights try to get 7 to 9 hours of sleep, you're going to feel better, you're going to have more energy, you're going to have a more positive outlook on life just because you're going to feel better and feel healthier, feel better about yourself. And so in turn, once you start feeling better and having that energy, then you're going to be able to study better. Okay, so don't put off sleep to study, at least not very often. Don't put off eating well to study. Don't put off your exercising and other healthy habits, okay? And same with your relationships. Now, sometimes you might have to tell your friends and other people in your life that you don't have time to go hang out with them, okay? This is mainly a lot of younger people who are maybe below the age of 20, 21, maybe just left high school recently. They struggle with this more than people who have been around a little longer, okay, who maybe already have their own families. This is mainly for younger people that struggle with this, is, you know, dealing with things like peer pressure and just making sure that you're studying and not going off and just doing whatever you want and just neglecting your studying, okay? Although some people that maybe are in their 30s or so, they might struggle with that too, but that's mainly something that people in their early adulthood, like maybe 17, I guess that's not technically an adult, but you know, 16, 17 year olds that drop out, 18, 19, 20, 21, who have a lot of friends and other peers in their life that really don't get that they're trying to be disciplined and trying to take their life seriously. Well, these other people just want to goof off and just get in trouble and do this or that, okay? If you're at that age, just know that you got to stay away from those people if you want to do well, or you at least have to be assertive and let people in your life know that you've got to study for the GED test. You can't be running off doing all, you're not going to have all this time time to go do all this fun stuff all the time. Now, you should have some kind of work-life balance. Okay, you shouldn't be studying all the time because you're going to go crazy. You are going to burn out eventually. But, you know, you got to make sure that you're not just going around and doing whatever you want. You do have to buckle down and be disciplined. And so, really, it's a lot harder for people that have families and have other stuff going on in their life where they've got to be responsible for other people, I think, because then your time may actually just be limited. But, you know, if you don't have kids, you don't have a family, and you just spend a lot of time with your friends, that's great. I'm not telling you don't be social, but you just have to put limits on it sometimes. And also, you might just need to make it clear that until you get your GED test done, you're not going to have as much time to hang out with people. And if they have a problem with that, then you're just going to have to decide, you know, if what do you care about more? Do you care about what these people think that are, you know, that don't respect that you're trying to pass the GED and get a better life? Or do you want to get good results with your GED test studying? Okay, and so anyway, the point here that I want to make is that you have to be realistic about your time, you have to be realistic about your energy, and you've got to take care of your relationships in your life with other people, but you do have to also still be assertive with other people who want to just take your time away from your studying. You know, for example, sometimes you might want to go spend time with family, because I believe that family does come first most of the time, but not all of the time, because there's got to be some time that you protect for yourself to get your studying done. Okay, so it's just as you study, you'll learn how to balance your time better. You'll get in the hang of it, but I just want you to be realistic about right from the get-go that, hey, you know, other areas of my life, I can't neglect them completely. Your relationships with friends and also spouses or significant others, and also your health and your lifestyle. Make sure that you really try to get those parts of your life down and taken care of, or at least so that you've got some calmness and clarity there, right? If you've got issues going on in your relationships with your significant other or your spouse, try to get that stuff worked out, because it is going to distract you and it's going to make it harder for you to study and to do well. Okay, so get the basic stuff down, like your sleep, your eating, your relationships. And, you know, I know that's not that easy for me to just sit here and tell you just go change your diet, go exercise more, and go cut people out of your life that are negative people. And that stuff is not easy, okay? That stuff can all be very, very hard. But really, until you start thinking about it and you start developing more clarity about what has to happen, you know, you have to understand that there are sacrifices that you're going to have to make in order to pass the GED test. You can't take more out of life than what you put in. You're going to have to put some time and you're going to have to put some effort into your GED test studying. And so in order to do that, though, successfully, you've got to sacrifice other things in your life, all right? And that may mean that, you know, you're going to have to cut out watching TV certain times, all right? Or you may have to cut out going to see a movie sometimes when you've got studying that you have to get done, all right? But you have to understand that you're giving up things that don't really matter that much in the long term in order to succeed in the long term. So as far as actual content on the GED test goes, once you get that basic stuff down, you understand, you know, how to manage your time, and you understand how to take care of yourself throughout the process, both with your mental health and both with your physical health, okay, then you're really ready to start taking off. And so a lot of people, they just jump right into their GED test studying, and they have no idea how they're going to cope with these demands that are going to come out from other people in their life, and demands on their health and, you know, their sleep, and they don't really have any kind of plan for that. So I'm just telling you right now, before the end of this video, just think about it. Or even after this video ends, just think about it. What are you going to do when you go to study and people start calling you and telling you to hang out? Or what are you going to do when you go to study and your family, your parents, your mom, your dad, other people in your life are telling you, hey, can you come help me with this? Can you come help me with that? You know, what are you going to do if people are just draining on your time all the time when for things that aren't emergencies or aren't that urgent? What are you going to do? What are you going to do when it comes to sleeping and making sure that you're going to get enough sleep and that you're going to eat at least moderately healthy and that you're going to get exercise? Think about that stuff now, and because it is going to be important. So after that, what you need to understand is that there are four subjects on the GED test. So the math, there's science, there's social studies, and there's reading and language arts. So I said reading and language arts, that's the fourth section. It is called reading and language arts, but it's one section. Reading and language arts, that stands for RLA, or I really shouldn't have said that the other way around. RLA stands for reading and language arts. So if you hear people talking about the RLA on the GED test, that stands for reading and language arts. And so the two sections that tend to be the hardest for people are your math and your language arts, or your reading language arts sections. Those tend to be the two hardest, okay? Now, that's not true for everybody. Some people really struggle with the science, and some people really struggle with the social studies, but generally speaking, it's that math and it's the reading and language arts that are going to struggle, that people will struggle with the most. So there's two different schools of thought about how to best approach taking down those sections, because you don't have to take all of those tests on the same day. And in fact, I recommend most people not to do that. So if you want to, you can schedule all four sections on the same day, get them all done, test all on the same day if you find a testing center that can accommodate that. But really, I don't recommend that for most people. I just think you're going to burn out. I just think it's going to be too much. And also, for the sake of cost, I say focus on one or two sections at a time, and just when you go to take a test, just take one test per day. For most people, you can, if you want, you can take two or three a day, but really understand that you're going to have to pay to schedule these tests. In Pennsylvania, where I'm at, it's about $30 a test. I believe it's $30, but some places it's $40 or $50. It can get expensive. So if you think about that, let's just say, you know, you've got, let's just say it's $30 in your state. Now, I don't know where you're at, so I'm just using Pennsylvania as an example, but here in Pennsylvania, it's $30 for one section. So you've got four sections. So to schedule each of those four sections, you've got to pay $30 each, okay? That's not cheap. What's 30 times four? That's 120. So just to schedule each section, that's $120. So that's another reason why it's not really a good idea to schedule them all at one time, because you're going to have to pay for them all at one time. So if you stagger it, you do maybe you start off your studying and then you do one every couple weeks or one every month or something like that. You're going to have to pay the same amount of money, but it's not going to be as it's not going to hit your wallet or your bank account as hard, hopefully, because you'll be spreading out the time that you're studying. You'll be spreading out the payments over time, rather than just knocking them all out in one day. You're going to have to pay that $120 all in one day. And instead of doing that, like I said, you'd be paying $30, you know, per section whenever you want. So you could do one a month or something like that for 4 months, and then you would be just be paying that $30, but you're paying it over a series of 4 months versus $120. So hopefully you guys get the point here. It's pretty simple what I'm saying here, but basically that's the way I recommend most people do it. And there's different schools of thought about the order in which to take those tests down. Some people want to start with the math because that is the hardest, and so they want to work on that. And then after they get the math down, they think everything else is going to be a lot easier. And that is true, but the thing is that if you go the other way and you start with your social studies or start with the science, which tend to be easier for some people, and again, that's a big generalization because some people really struggle with those sections, but if you start with the social studies and start with the science, you might get some confidence going. If you start with the social studies and you get a big win, you pass the social studies, you might get some confidence going, all right? Or if you pass the science, you'll get some confidence going. So going into that math, although math tends to be the harder section compared to social studies and science, you're going to have that momentum and that confidence. So when you go to study for the math and study for the RLA, you're going to feel more confident, all right? So it just really just depends on how you want to approach it. And you don't just have to study for one subject at a time, but I would say maybe I would do two at a time. Maybe I would start off with your reading and language arts or your math, and then at the same time you could look at some social studies, look at some reading and language arts. But those are really, it's really two good ones to start with, are your RLA and your math. That's the way I usually recommend people to do it, because those are the hardest, and so you can get those done, and then the other two usually will go a lot faster. But some people, like I said, they just need that confidence boost of starting with the easier sections and getting those down. Now, the best place to start for free, which you can start right now, besides YouTube, which obviously I'm preaching to the choir because you're watching this on YouTube, but you'll want to go to the GED Testing Services website. You can just put in GED.com or something like that into Google, but go to the GED Testing Service official website and log in or create your account, and then you can log in there and you can get previews of all the sections. Like, they give you mini study guides. They don't really give you like a whole lot of information about what you need to know, but they'll give you some basic, you know, practice examples, and they'll give you some basic overviews, and you can start seeing some of the types of questions that you'll have to answer for each of those four sections. And so that's really going to help you out. So definitely go make an account on the GED official website. And then when you go to schedule your test sections, all you do is you go in through the GED website. I have another video where I show you how to schedule your test sections, but it's pretty self-explanatory. You make your account on the GED website, then you can schedule your test sections. You just put in your zip code and they'll show you testing centers near you. You just pick where you want to go. You make your payments and then you go and you test. And also, before you take a real test, I highly, highly, highly recommend doing an official practice test from the GED testing service. So the GED testing service, for $6, they let you take practice tests that are almost identical to the real thing in the setup. So the setup and the way that the practice tests look is going to be almost identical, or it is going to be identical to the real test. The question types are going to be very similar. And so for people who do multiple practice tests, like they do two or three, some people I've even heard of doing like six practice tests, but that might be a little bit too much for most people. That might be a little bit overkill, but some people that's really going to help them. But, you know, I recommend doing usually at least one, okay? But usually you want to do two, maybe even three, because the first one that you do is usually just to see where you're at and to see what you need work on. So a good strategy after you're done with this video is to go on the GED website, look at the information that they give you for free, the types of questions that they show you that may come up on the test, take a practice test and see where you're at, and it's going to help you predict your score. It's going to give you a likely to pass score if you're likely to pass, and it's going to tell you if you're not ready, if you're not likely to pass, it's going to tell you. It might also give you a too close to call score if you're close, but the computer can't quite judge whether you would be likely to pass on the real thing or not. So most people, their first practice test, they do really bad on, they kind of bomb it. And so if that happens to you, don't worry about it. Just look at your score report and look at the types of questions that you didn't do well on and really double or triple down on those topics. So go find the topics that you didn't do well on and learn how to do those. So just type them into Google, type them into YouTube. That's a good way to start. Also, you'll want to get a prep book and you can look them up there. So some people can pass the GED test without using a prep book, but most people, I do recommend you get a prep book. Kaplan works. Some people don't like Kaplan because they say it's really dense and it has all the information that you need, but it's dense and like some people get more confused, but I would recommend a test prep book. I usually recommend Kaplan just because they give you a lot of practice. There's practice tests and all kinds of practice problems, and practice really is so important, and Kaplan seems to be the most popular, but it's not the only thing out there. There are other really, really great books, other guides out there that work. You can check out my description below. I put some of the best ones that I like down in the description that I've recommended to people and that I've had people do before and that people have had success with and that I've tried myself with students in person during tutoring sessions. But really, I think that the combination of having a good test prep book and that's comprehensive and supplementing that with YouTube videos and then taking practice tests, for most people, if you're working with those materials, a prep book, and also YouTube videos, over the course of a few months, maybe 1 to 3 months, most people can expect to be done. Some people it's going to take longer, and of course, this depends on how much time you can put in per week. If you can only study for a couple hours a week, I would say it's probably going to take you 3 to 6 months, or maybe even a whole year if you can only do a couple hours a week. But other people, if you're able to put in maybe 5 or 6 hours a week, 5 to 8 hours a week, something like that, within a couple of months, I would say that's probably realistic to expect to be done. But some people are different. Some people, they put in 4 or 5 hours a day and it takes them 3 to 6 months to pass. It just depends on where you're at. But I think for most people, being able to pass in 3 to 6 months is a realistic goal. Some people, it only takes them a month. Some people, it only takes them a couple weeks. It just depends on where you're at. Some people, it takes them 1 week. It just depends on where you're at, but there really is no set time that it should take you to pass. It just depends on where you're at right now. So another tip that I have for you is to really, on your test, when you go in to take that real test, don't waste too much time on any one question. Just try to keep moving throughout the GED test, okay? If you get to questions that you don't understand how to do, definitely just guess and move on, all right? You can use a mark feature. There's a little feature, it's going to be up at the top corner of your test where you can mark a question, and then at the end of the test, if you have extra time, you can go back and check those questions again. So that's one of the best tips I have for really doing well on your test is expect that there's going to be some questions that you don't know how to do and you want to try them and you want to take a stab at them because you never know, you might be able to get them right. But don't waste too much time on questions if they're just stuff that you've never studied or stuff that you have no idea how to do. You don't have to know everything to pass the GED test. You don't even have to know, I would say, you don't even have to know most of the stuff. If you get about half of the questions right on the GED test, you'll probably pass, okay? Again, if you know enough material to get about half of those questions right, you're probably going to pass, all right? So understand that you do want to try to know as much stuff as you can for the test, but don't stress out about mastering every single little detail like the back of your hand. It's usually not necessary. If you want to get a really, really high score, then yes, you all have to do that. But if you just want to pass, you want to try to learn a little bit about everything, and you don't necessarily have to master everything, but you want to try to learn a little bit about enough of the topics that you're going to be able to get a likely to pass score on your GED practice test. And if you can do that, then you're going to be in really, really good shape. And once you get a likely to pass score, then still review your practice tests and still review your results, but don't wait too much longer after that. Just go into your test with confidence, and there's no guarantee, but that's just life. There's no guarantee in life, but if you can get a likely to pass score, you most likely know enough stuff to pass. It's just a matter of just making sure that you go into your test, you stay calm and composed, and that you do well and that you test well and you go into it with confidence, and then you're probably going to pass. So hopefully this video helped you out, guys, if you're just starting with your GED studying. And this is Parker from Desperate Champions wishing you the best of luck on your test. And good luck, guys. Let me know how you do down below.